Steve's relationship with Otis was kind of special, and his reputation was sealed. He would go on to work with everyone from Rod Stewart to Eric Clapton to the Blues Brothers. And as a sideman, that's what you need, a reputation. Because the artists you work with don't always have work for you. But if you are lucky, someone else might. And my luck was certainly in when I got a call in 1980. So I hadn't seen David Bowie since 76, and I got a phone call from the producer, Jack Douglas, and he said, oh, I got this essence for Slicky, and who is it? I can't tell you. But after 3 or 4 days, I kind of figured it out. It was John Lennon. I was a little nervous. I don't get nervous. That one made me nervous. John had certain session guys that he had used. And John said, well, I need a wild card in here. I need a street player that can't read, that it's just like me, irreverent and does what he wants. That's how I got the gig. It was not a challenge working with John at all because he left me alone to do what I wanted to do. Of my career. It really was. And not just my career, my life. I loved it. John just let me loose. When I'm with one of the so-called stars, I feel like a peer. You know, that's the way I'm treated. I'm treated like a peer. I was really lucky to work with both David and John in a period that I now see as the heyday for our sideies, the 70s and the 80s. At this time, there were superstar solo artists who needed sidemen and respected the role they played. And